I'm Draco.
You know who I'm dating?
Who is you dating?
Harry Potter.
You're dating.
This is Ibrew.
12 Pro Extra Long.
50 points for Slytherin, but not Slytherin in this what?
Good, like, voice, like
Professor McGonagall!
Yes!
You think I have a Professor McGonagall voice?
Not anymore.
Now you have that annoying bitch that's
Whoa, whoa! Welcome, welcome!
That's good, that's good, that's good.
All of the food of the wizarding world
yes.
will be taught in today's semester. First, we will start with the infamous Butterbeer. We've got this cup called Butterbeer in the leaky bits. It's a new restaurant that has recently opened up, and it's Leaky Bits.
It's actually really cool. Stephanie spent a lot of time on it.
I really did. And it will literally fall off the minute that I wash it.
When you say Leaky Bits, yes. What does that mean?
Well, it's quite obvious, Weasley. The bits is leaking. 50 points from Gryffindor for dumb questions.
I'm not even Gryffindor.
50 points for Slytherin, but not Slytherin. Here's how I feel. I feel as if my Harry Potter obsession has really finally reached a climax in order to surpass to, you know, Wingardium Leviosa, Expelliarmus, my obsession with the wizarding world. I need to do a video. So like whenever I research cases, I absorb all this information and then I release it in a Patronus. AKA a YouTube video, and then it exits my brain. But with Harry Potter, it has not exited my brain. And so I'm hoping that making this video will just collect all of my Harry Potter thoughts and just fucking Expelliarmus that shit out of my brain. Look at this. It's a Harry Potter cauldron. It's got a lid, and it's got an inside, and it's got a spoon on the inside, and you're just and make some potions. So today, we're gonna be dressing up as Harry Potter. It's not even Halloween! We're gonna be making three things that I've been dying to taste from the wizarding world. I've already had Butterbeer, but we're gonna make a different version of Butterbeer that I've never had. And then we're also gonna be make pumpkin pasties. Pumpkin pasties! And we're also making golden snitch cake pops. And then we're gonna watch Harry Potter together tonight. And these chopsticks are my best chopsticks, and I'm gonna be making them into wands.
How, you ask?
Well, I saw that there was a DIY tutorial where you get a hot glue gun and you do some shit and then you spray paint it or whatever. On second thought, that's gonna take too long. I might just use this. This is a simple wand. So I got these. I know the lighting's a little bit weird, but I got these too because they're kid sizes, so they're a lot more affordable than the adult sizes. And they're both Gryffindor. I couldn't find Slytherin for you, so you're just gonna pretend to be Gryffindor. Well, I do have this. So I'm gonna go full out. I stole a tie from your tie section, and I'm gonna wear that underneath my cape, and you are gonna wear a Slytherin shirt.
What is this?
I bought it for you.
This is the worst.
I bought it for you.
Why? Cast a spell, and then you're gonna change into Harry Potter, okay? Who are you, by the way?
I'll be Harry, and you be Draco, and we'll have some little thing going on. We can do a little role play, and then you're like, Potter.
Potter.
And then I'm like, eh. Malfoy.
All right, ready? You filthy
Potter.
Stupid boy.
It's supposed to be something cool, like okay. Dressy. Ready?
You filthy
Potter.
Stupid Filio.
Bruh.
Wow! I feel like I should be at Hogwarts. I'm student Stephanie Bean Sprout.
I thought you're Harry.
Oh yeah, I'm Harry Potter.
Where's your glasses? Where's the scar, Harry?
The scar? It's called makeup. Have you heard of her? Anyways,
what is that?
It's the firebolt.
Hold on, I got a broom too.
You have a broom?
Yes.
Please don't ride over here with your broom on. Oh no, can you show them your broom?
This is the newest innovation from Apple.
This is iBroom.
12 Pro extra long. Most people get the regular 12. This is 12 Pro
extra long.
Yeah, I don't know what kind of broom you're having. Mine's much more
updated and faster.
One of us didn't buy my way onto the team, Draco. I really hate ourselves. I don't even know if I want to edit and post this video because already I'm dying. Alright guys, so this is going to be a Wattpad fanfiction of Harry Potter and Draco Malfoy. Stephanie Bean Sprout will be portraying Harry Potter. And Panda will be portraying Draco Malfoy.
What does that mean? Does that mean they have a thing?
Yeah.
How does that work?
Like they hate each other, but they also wanna...
But they also sword fight.
Malfoy, catch me if you can. If you do, maybe I'll find your golden snitch.
Harry, I always hated you, but you know what? The way you fly on that broom?
I can ride the bear.
For Harry?
Yes.
Are you Harry?
I'm Harry.
But like, are you Harry?
I'm freshly waxed like a little seal. Expelliarmus hair from my bod. I'm ruining Harry Potter for myself. I'm literally holding a chopstick as a wand. We had this conversation, but how would you hold your wand? So I've seen Voldemort holds it like this or something.
I gotta hold it like this.
He said he's holding it like this, like chopsticks.
Yeah, because I'm Chinese.
And then, you know, you see like some of the fancy people, they're all like this. And the noobs be like this. And then that's me, I'm like
ding. You're like,
so welcome to potions class. Professor Snape has been fired.
Professor Snape is dead.
No, he's not dead yet. Like, stop. We're like in the Chamber of Secrets right now, okay? Like, we're not there yet. Professor Snape will be missing today's potions class. So me, Professor Stephanie Bean Sprout, will be taking over. Everybody has your school-assigned cauldrons, yes? Place them in front of yourself, and we will get to be brewing a Butterbeer potion. This potion is meant for putting people to sleep.
I thought Butterbeer is for fourth graders.
Silence! Butterbeer is...
Is Professor Bean Sprout on menopause?
On menopause?
I'm Draco. Do you know who I am?
I know who the fork you are, bitch.
Do you know who my dad is?
I know who your daughter is.
Do you know who I'm dating?
Who is your dating?
Harry Potter.
Oh. Wouldn't it be ironic if the boy who lived dated the boy who died? Shut up in my class.
You think we can cancel for this?
Anyways, everybody get your cauldrons out and we will be making Butterbeer.
Yay.
Okay, so here's what you're gonna need for this potions class of Butterbeer. You're actually not going to need the asshole hair of a butter dragon.
This is the first time I'm learning about butter dragon. Can you tell us more about butter dragon?
So a butter dragon is actually from the land of Butterways. And it's actually comparable to the Chinese fireball in terms of, instead of breathing fire, it actually just throws up this liquid hot butter onto its victims. They're highly uncontrollable and absolutely untamable. And if you ever see one in the Forbidden Forest, I suggest you run, Draco.
I actually fought a Chinese fireball before.
I actually probably ate one too.
Oh, me too.
You nasty professor.
You're gonna get two little gruesome. molasses, and with this I've actually only used real clarified butter before, but this recipe calls for red. Now this butter extract, you can actually get it from the Forbidden Forest of Amazon Prime. You're gonna need to put half a teaspoon of this onto the bottom of your glass. So this is actually a butter flavor. It's not the real butter from the Butter Dragon, but it's pretty close. We like to use this because it's more sustainable and you don't have to go chasing butter dragons in your free time. Then you're gonna go grab a cream soda and gently pour.
So are we like
hashtag save the dragons?
Yes!
You can put rum, but I'm not going to. Do you want to help, Draco? Or are you just going to sit there like the useless little bits that you wore? Now you're gonna open your bottle of heavy whipping cream. This is actually found in unicorn's blood. It's a highly valuable ingredient to get.
So Professor, you've seen unicorns before?
I have. So you're gonna need 2 cups of the whipping heavy cream.
Professor?
Yes?
Is heavy creams actually heavy?
Oh, it's so heavy, but I've actually put a magical enchantment on this to make it light as a feather.
You're so cool, Professor.
Thank you.
I wish one day I could be like you when I grow up.
Oh, but you will never be half the witch that I am. It's bubbling!
Wow, that looks like some dark magic.
You are the most annoying kid. I want you expelled! You get detention in the Forbidden Forest with Hagrid and Filch.
Who's Filch?
You're gonna hear about this from my dad.
You're gonna hear about me from your dad if you don't shut up!
What?
You're going to want to whisk your cauldron with the heavy cream until it's got the consistency of troll flesh. And if you think you're done, you're not done, so whisk a little more. Perfect. Now you're gonna need 6 tablespoons of your grandmother's ashes.
But my grandmother is alive.
Seems like a personal problem.
And then now you're going to need to beat it for some longer time.
Professor?
Yes?
Which house were you in?
Gryffindor?
I think they're done, Professor. Yeah, I think you overwhipped it.
You're overwhipped and I'm overworked. You've done absolutely nothing in this class, Draco, so shut the f*** up. 2 teaspoons vanilla. Oh, what a worrisome thing. I almost used tablespoons. We're just going to put a little bit more vanilla there, aren't we? And then from there, we're going to move on with the more butter from the Butter Dragon. This is a heavy dragon recipe. And then you're just going to want to put in maybe about 1/2 teaspoon.
Is there dragon harmed in the making of this video?
Absolutely. We've killed so many in the Forbidden Forest. Anyways, you keep whipping until it's fully mixed. If you go to Diagon Alley, there's this place called Chefney's, and they have so many amazing...
I thought they said they're sold out.
Yes! Oh, my golly! You can use whatever spoon you have at home. But, you know, keep checking Diagon Alley, the place called Chefney's, and eventually, maybe in 2021, they will restock the magical spoons. Mm-hmm. Anyways... You plop this on top.
Huh.
I think I overwhipped it.
That's what I said.
I'm sorry, Draco. Were you a butterbeer expert? Not exactly. Oh, delicious. Here's a butterbeer for you.
Wow.
You know, if I used a regular cream soda, it would have had the...
Whoa, that was cool.
That was cool. Now, I'm not going to put as much in the Leaky Biss cup because, again, this I got from a place called the Leaky Biss. It's actually not as leaky as people might assume. And now you've got...
Whoa, that looks so cool.
That is the thickest cream. No butterbeer came through. This is a better recipe.
It's leaking.
That's okay. That's the whole point of the Leaky Biss. This is a spectacular potion. Oh, it is purely leaking. It's just a
What happened to you, like, Harry?
What do you mean?
I thought you were better than this.
You know, it's really hard to focus in school and be the chosen one at the same time.
You Potterhead?
You're a Potterhead! Also, speaking of, I do want to mention, you guys know how it's called a Horcrux? My fiance has been calling it a Horcrack. And I'm
Horcrux.
Horcrux.
Anyways, Professor, I think class is about to be over.
Class is about to be over, but we're not done cooking, so I'm gonna try to see what happens if I type in Harry Potter under Postmates, because I don't know if I want to cook anything else.
Is that some kind of dark magic too?
Postmates?
Yeah.
It's real dark. So I'm searching up Harry Potter on the Postmates, on the Uber Eats. I'm gonna order something because I really wanted to make pumpkin pasties. But if I do, I'm gonna miss the trolley.
The trolley?
I'm gonna miss the Hogwarts Express.
Where are you going?
I'm going to Diagon Alley to go to Chevenix. It's the place to be these days. Everybody's there. Silence! I feel like my voice is switching back and forth between
Professor McGonagall
and Dolores Umbridge.
That was good.
Welcome, students. Headmaster Dumbledore is gone for the day, so I, Professor Beansprout, will be taking over. It is our end of the year feast at Hogwarts. Another year has passed at the Wizarding School. I suspect that this year has been unsettling to some of you, you know, with the whole trolls making out with students in the hallways.
It's a weird sight to see.
But you know, troll love is still love.
Yeah, who won the house cup?
So the house cup, according to this house cup hat, the hat is telling me.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine.
Gryffindor with 220 points. Slytherin with 250 points. And in first place,
motherfucking Hufflepuff,
5,697 points. Hufflepuff.
There's no way, Professor. That
I disagree.
A Slytherin? Zip it. Nobody cares, Malfoy.
My boyfriend will care about this.
Welcome to my first Harry Potter mukbang. We've got our pumpkin pasties, aka pumpkin and cream pies from
the magical ministry of McDonald's.
Yes, and then inside of this cauldron, we've got Severus Snape's infamous popcorn recipe. There's caramel popcorn. And then in this little thing, we've got more pasties. We've got some beef pasties, some ham and cheese pasties. We've got, of course, a butter beer. And then we also have, this one's called Mommy's Pumpkin Spiced Potion. It's an ice cream. How's the pasty?
This is delicious.
Mm.
Who made these?
The house elves in the Hogwarts kitchen.
Don't worry!
We pay them!
I don't know. Hermione's triggered.
Please try the ham.
Wow, these are good.
Mm, delicious.
Well, house elves are just multi-talented.
Mm. Now, if you may, a pumpkin pasty. Do you guys want to know the history of Dementors? So where they come from is there was this island and there was this really powerful wizard that was, you know, he was insane. He was a Looney Tune. He liked to kidnap sailors. Just in the middle of this like sea, there was a tiny island and he would stay there and he would produce all these spells to get sailors to crash on his shores and then he would have fun tormenting them, torturing them until they finally died. That's how he got his happiness. Now, obviously he was regarded as one of the most powerful wizards at the time, and he just really didn't care for power like Voldemort did. He really just wanted seclusion and to torture people in peace. And so on this tiny little island, he had hidden it from the Muggle map and the Ministry of Magic's map. So no one even knew that this island existed. And that's when he built this ginormous castle, and inside of those castles, whether they came about or he breeded them, but Dementors started forming. It seems like he had created them with all that dark magic. Now, he would use these Dementors to suck the souls out of those sailors. He did this for quite some time until eventually he passed away. And that's when the Ministry of Magic saw, because the protective spell and the hiding spell had lifted off the island, they saw it. So they all went to go investigate because they knew that a powerful wizard was associated with it. So they arrive, and none of the ministers of magic actually talk about that day because
Your accent,
Professor?
Oh, yes! I forgot to take some more polyjuice potion. They realized, you know, these are some of the craziest creatures they've ever seen in their lives. And they were so scared, none of them, even to this day, they will not talk about that day that they went to Azkaban. That's when they were like, okay, well, what do we do with Azkaban? And what do we do with these Dementors? And, you know, should we kill that building? Because they said it seemed like depression.
Oh, that was Azkaban?
Yeah, and they said that the walls of those buildings on the island had, like, it just was screaming of depression and just darkness and some of the worst magic that they'd ever seen. And they thought to themselves, well, if we take away the Dementors' home, then the Dementors might go and kill a bunch of wizards and muggles. And we can't have that. And, you know, it seems like they would get very angry at us for killing their home. And so they left them there for quite some time. In the Ministry of Magic, they had multiple fights over what to do with this island. At the time, the Minister of Magic was Diggory, Cedric Diggory's great-great-great whatever. Mm-hmm. I don't know how up in his ancestry, but Cedric Diggory, you know him from Hufflepuff. And the Diggorys are not very fond of torturing people, so they absolutely refused to create a prison. Now, prior to Azkaban, there was practically no prison that was unescapable for wizards, and it was so hard to make sure that the surrounding perimeters of these wizard prisons, there was no muggles, because a lot of the times prisoners would escape, or they'd make loud noises trying to escape, or they'd see all these sparks go up while they tried to escape, and the smells, apparently there were some weird smells coming out of the prisons, and all of these muggles would have so many questions, so the ministers were just running around, like giving the muggles some charms to forget. Now, continuing on, Diggory gets repassed by a different person, and that person decides to make that island Azkaban.
I did not know that.
The name itself was inspired by Alcatraz.
From the Muggle world.
From the Muggle world.
Wow.
Exactly.
Them freaking Muggles.
Why is this wet?
Why is my wand wet? Troll boogers!
Shut up.
Honestly, I'm living out my dreams right now.
Me too.
Really?
I love it.
Did you know there are so many wizarding schools all across the world?
How many?
Oh, I think there's like at least 15. The biggest ones, though, are the three that practice in the Tri-Wizard Tournament. You've got Durmstrang, you've got Beauxbatons, you've got Hogwarts. And then there's one that's really, really famous in Japan. And that's where Nagini.
Nagini?
Did you know the snake was actually a witch who could transform into a snake like Professor McGonagall transforms into a cat? But then she got stuck in her snake form.
Why?
And she was so, I don't know, something happened.
She was just very lonely when she became a snake.
You know, not many people speak parcel tongue. You should know that. Your boyfriend speaks parcel tongue.
Yeah, my boyfriend speaks it all the time.
Ew! Draco!
In the middle of
okay, alright, I don't
day,
know. Okay.
He's just like, stupid!
You know what? It's delicious, but it's not as good as my mummy's. I mean, it's titled Mummy's Pumpkin Spiced Potion. This tastes like what I think a candle would taste like.
Mm-hmm. I have a pumpkin spice candle, and I think it tastes exactly like this.
Anyways, semester has adjourned. Please be safe and remember, no underage magic outside of Hogwarts.
And I'll see you next year, Professor.
See you next year.